Although the priesthood was always in the back of my mind, I really didn't know how to respond to that calling and how to even go about becoming a priest or seminary, what all that meant. I really didn't know enough even about Christ or the Catholic Church to be able to respond to that.
In many conversations with God, what do you want me to do? What is the greater purpose of this? What am I doing with my life? Go to school, go to class, come home. There's gotta be something more. You know, his answer was, you're an educator and you're out there to educate kids.
After my father died, I left my mom with six kids. Then the church was everything to us. It's always been important throughout all of my career as a social worker, as a wife, as a sibling.
Our studies, in addition to giving us some of the know-how for our ministry, really helped to bring about a deeper personal relationship with the Lord. Outside of that, we also have different forms of ministry, like being an extraordinary minister of Holy Communion, teaching catechism in a parish, and now as a deacon, my ministry is on the weekends at a parish.
We are entering a world where technology is the thing. And when I got to the school and saw that we had zero equipment, zero curriculum, that was the challenge. What programs do they need so that they can have those skills? We have to look at the long term and where our students are going to go. And then also, because we're a Catholic school, how are we then developing the programs in their faith?
Our soup kitchen and food pantry are truly a blessing to the community of Brightmoor because we practice radical hospitality by meeting people where they are, wherever that is, be it at the street corner, at their house, in the soup kitchen or food pantry. They say that they're happy that St. Christine's is there. Many times they tell me that.
I'm very thankful to God for the generosity of the people in the Archdiocese. To have a lot of people behind me with their prayers and other means of support really helped me. I'm not even a priest yet, so like I'm not doing anything to earn or deserve that. They're generous because they love the Lord, and they know that it's the priesthood that allows Jesus to work in his church.
With the fund from last year, we were able to gain some new iPads. We got the laptops for the students. We were able to upgrade so that all students had a license. It's important to have those dollars because otherwise our students would be left behind.
Without the soup kitchen or food pantry, the families that receive those services would have to make choices as to whether to feed their children or pay their bills. It is their lifeline. It's their hope that every day that door is going to open at 10 o'clock, that one of us is going to be there, a friendly face is going to say, come on in.
My name is Deacon Derek Peterman. I'm in my sixth and last year at Sacred Heart Major Seminary in Detroit, studying for the priesthood.
I'm Karina Lipkowski. I am serving as the interim principal at Most Holy Trinity, a preschool through eighth grade building.
My name is Maureen Northrup, and I'm the Christian Service Coordinator at St. Christine's Christian Services, which includes a soup kitchen, food pantry, and St. Vincent de Paul services.
To live fully as a disciple of Jesus Christ means following his commission to make disciples of the whole world. Each year, when you support the Catholic Services Appeal, you answer the call to witness to Jesus. Your gift fuels the engine of the mission of our Archdiocese. More than 100 ministries touching countless souls in Southeast Michigan. From my heart, I thank you for your generous support of our shared mission to open doors to witness Christ.